there are few points which are should be done before doing compression suture. Patient should be given lithotomy position so that assistant can check the vaginal bleeding. Second, always check the local bleeding from the uterine cavity. If there is any local bleeder, hemostatic stitches, figure of 8, should be taken before taking compression suture. Always compress uterus manually and check the vaginal bleeding stops. Then only your compression suture is going to work. So just check the potential efficacy of compression suture by manually compressing uterus and checking the bleeding. The preference of this stage is the monofilament monocryl 1 number. That is the ideal suture because it is monofilament, so chances of infection is less. It has enough strength and it is absorbable. So the complications after doing stitches are less. And needle which we use should be either straight needle or the 70 mm round body needle. So always keep these two needles in your drum. Whatever stitch you prefer, you can always take that stitch. But needle preferably should be the straight needle or 70 mm needle. I'll take a B-link suture first. Just take the stitch in 3 cm below the lower edge and it should be 3 cm medial to the lateral edge. Similarly, exit from the 3 cm above the incision, upper edge of incision. Ask assistant to apply artery, otherwise it will come out. Then loop the stitch over the fundus and ask the to bend the uterus anteriorly. Loop the thread over the fundus. Just keep it tight. See that myometrium is not injured because of this stitch. And then you enter the uterine cavity from posterior uterine wall, same level of the lower segment incision, 3 cm away from the lateral part, and come out 3 cm medial to the lateral border from opposite side. The inside stitch will be horizontal in the uterine cavity. Now again loop the stitch over the fundus. Both this fundal stitch should be 4 cm away from the corno because this is broader than this. Make it enough tight and ask assistant to hold it. And now again take this similar stitch as you have taken on right side, 3 cm above the upper edge. Hi, sir. Take out stitch 3 cm below the lower edge. Okay. Tight both the stitches together and ask assistant to compress the uterus. You can see, you can appreciate how it is compressed. Now keep it held long, close the lower incision and then tighten the stitch over the lower uterine segment. This is another stage which is for the PPH, bleeding from the placenta previa and the bleeding from the placental bed. This was also described by B. Lynch, where you have to enter at the same level of lower uterine incision posteriorly, 3 cm medial to the lateral edge, and come out in the uterine cavity. Take out needle. Again,
to exit the needle from the posterior uterine wall 3 cm medial and 3 cm below and 3 cm medial to the lateral edge. Now rotate it anteriorly and take one stitch. Stitch is transfixed to the lower uterine segment. Take a 1 cm bite in the lower uterine segment just below the incision. Similarly, take stitch on the opposite side. Here also you have to enter from the posterior uterine wall 3 cm medial and 3 cm below the incision. Take out needle in the uterine cavity. And again exit needle from posterior uterine wall above the incision. Keep it held long and close the lower uterine incision, and after closing this you have to tie this stitch and check the vaginal bleeding. It should stop. Beauty of this stitch, this compresses the lower uterine segment and it also ligates the uterine from below and above. So this is the vascular ligation plus compression stitch. Hemen stitch. The advantage of this stitch, if we have closed the uterine segment and still we feel that it is a tonic PPH, we can take this stitch without opening the incision. Dissect the bladder down and take the stitch anteriorly and take it out posteriorly. And then loop it over the fundus and held it long.
Okay.
Take it out and then loop the thread over the fundus and then held it long. Take similar stitch on the opposite side and now tie one by one each stitch over the fundus and ask assistant to compress the uterus. This is very important step. Need a assistant. You can see the compression of the uterus. This is how the compression suture works. The advantage of that, this is very easy to take. It does not take much of a time and there is no need to open the incision. And this also can be done when there is no cesarean section. This is extension of the Hemen stitch, which is known as safety pin stitch, where in similar way after pushing the bladder, there is no need to open lower uterine incision again. Push the bladder down and take a stitch through and through the uterine cavity 3 cm medial to the lateral edge and take out the needle posteriorly. Then loop the stitch over the fundus, re-enter cavity 3 cm below the fundus and take out stitch posteriorly the same level. This will transfix the stitch to the uterus and there won't be slippage of the stitch. Ask the assistant to compress the uterus and tie the stitch. Similar stitch is taken on the opposite side and then tie it one by one. Parera stitch is the stitches, multiple vertical stitches are taken, just have to enter the uterine cavity anterior to posterior. Take the stitch out and then take stitches in the wall only. Don't enter the cavity. Loop the stitch over the fundus. And held it long. Take similar stitches 4-5 depending on the width of the uterus, and at the end you tie all the stitches. These are vertical stitches. Similarly, stitches are taken transversely also, encircling uterus and tied. That is the U stitch. So vertical stitches and the transverse stitches together make complete compression of the uterus.